finally got on the train. Wait, where's the driver?
The SkyTrain is how nearly 400,000 Vancouverites commute every day, and it's probably the closest many Americans may get to the London Underground. Yet, a fact known to few outside Vancouver, not even myself when I went to Vancouver last weekend, is that all three lines are completely automated. I thought I'd have to go to Dubai to see that. I still want to, though. In 2006, it was the longest fully automated metro system in the world, until it was beaten by the Dubai Metro. Though it may not still be the longest in the world, it still has a very reliable schedule, as trains come every 15 minutes or so, whereas the Max Light Rail here in Portland comes every 15 minutes per line. And I don't want to tell you how many times I've had to wait for a train for nearly 10 minutes at the station served by three lines. Not only that, but it also has a punctuality rate of 96%, with the only delays really caused by people blocking the doors because you can't automate stupidity. It's completely safe, but some trains have emergency control panels, just in case. There are many advantages to automated metros, including reliable service, as the trains can coordinate with one another to know when the next station is open, hence the previous point. You also don't have to worry about drivers having to go to the other side of the train at terminus stations, and you can use the space to provide an area where you can pretend and drive the train, if that's the sort of thing you're into. I'm kidding, I'm totally not judging you at all. It also helps us get one step closer to taking human drivers off the roads, and as long as it's all in a closed system, as in you don't have to worry about hacking, the only real downside is...
Alright, Mr. Thomas Giamatti, welcome to TransLink. What position are you seeking in our company?
Yeah, I was thinking about applying for a job as one of those SkyTrain drivers, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got some bad news for you.
Seriously though, you better hope it's all in a closed system, because...
All passengers, did you remember to pay off the Prince of Nigeria yet?
But will this actually become more common? Well, aside from airport people movers, quite a few cities around the world have an automated metro, or at least a metro in which a couple of the lines are automated. These include cities like Dubai, Sao Paulo, Paris, Rome, Budapest, guess that's how pronounced, etc. So, will this catch on? Well, we'll have to wait and see, but in the meantime, please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more videos every week. I will see you on Sunday.